Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. Manchester firefighters are being hailed as heroes after pulling a man from a burning building this morning and then bringing him back to life. The man was unconscious on the floor of his burning apartment at a public housing facility on Lowell Street when firefighters reached him. Sean McDonald has the story.
Well, I heard pounding on my window. Dun, dun, dun. Gotta get out. There's a fire. And then there was people coming down the stairs. You gotta get out.
That was how Melissa Melly and other residents of 295 Lowell Street were awoken just after midnight Monday. Fire was raging in a second floor apartment. Lieutenant Pete Frangus and other firefighters donned full gear and on their hands and knees felt their way through the black smoke until they found the lifeless body of 56-year-old Arthur Cosmas.
We went up to the second floor, forced the door, put water on a fire, and rescue one came upon a victim.
Cosmas had no pulse and wasn't breathing as he was pulled from the building. Frightened residents could only watch.
They were giving him CPR, and he was having trouble breathing, and he didn't look well at all.
Finally, I heard one of the EMTs saying that they got him back. They got a pulse.
Fire crews managed to bring him back, and the victim was rushed from the scene with smoke inhalation and burns to his legs. The chief says the cause was accidental. Improper disposal of smoking materials ignited the mattress. He also says two of the smoke detectors inside the apartment were disabled. As for the team that saved the resident's life, they say it's all part of the job.
You know, there'll be people out there who say, you know, there's a group of heroes last night at work. What do you say to that?
No, that's what we get paid to do.
Arthur Cosmas was taken to Mass General, where he was last listed in critical condition. The fire was contained to his unit. Because of water damage, two residents will have to live somewhere else for a couple of days. A Windham school bus driver was arrested for driving under the influence as she dropped students off to a school this morning. Apparently, a number of people called police to report that a bus was driving erratically, and an officer found 50-year-old Kimberly Hooley of Londonderry pulling her bus into the town's middle school. The officer says Hooley insisted that she had not been drinking and passed a breathalyzer test, but police say that she failed a field sobriety test and told them that she had taken prescription drugs. Police say Hooley also told them that she had hit a mailbox on her route, causing minor damage to that school bus. The school superintendent says students did find a beer can on that bus. The school says that Hooley will no longer be driving for the district. Students in Andover got an unexpected day off from school today after police say someone smashed the windows on several buses. This is what was the scene when drivers arrived at the bus yard this morning. Left crews with a lot of cleanup to do. Ray Brewer has the story.
Workers cleaning out the buses finished what the vandals had started. The superintendent of Andover Schools, Mike Martin, says someone tossed rocks through the rear windows of five buses, making them unsafe to bring the students to school. Martin says he found out about the damage around 5:15 in the morning, had no choice but to cancel school.
And we went about getting the word out by calling board members and calling the principal and notifying teachers and calling it into the media.
The closure affected some 300 students in grades K through 12 in Andover and also their parents.
Well, you say, I don't think I'm going to be able to be fully engaged in work today because children are home from school.
Something that Jennifer Reno's children didn't seem to mind as they played on the swings. Reno says she caught a bit of a break because she can do a lot of work from home.
And so, fortunately for me, I'm here and it worked. Emergency works. But for other parents, I can't imagine.
Boys, awesome!
Some of the younger children ended up at this daycare. Doreen Peralt says usually they have some warning, but not this time.
We just got extra staff in at the last minute. Phones started ringing about 6 o'clock this morning, people looking for care for their kids.
Peralt says they'll end up with about 33% more children than normal. And while they'll cope, she added she is disappointed to learn that vandalism of the buses was the reason school was closed.
We knew a couple months ago Merrimack Valley had an incident at the end of the school year. We were very disappointed and surprised to hear that something like that would happen in Andover here.
Now, during the last school year, vandals hit school buses in two nearby towns, but the superintendent says he does not believe that this incident is connected to the others. Well, starting tonight at 5 o'clock, thousands of dollars worth of cell phones stolen from a mall kiosk, and the suspects are caught on surveillance video. What else we're learning about this robbery? And a hospital room is supposed to be a sterile, safe environment, but what about those curtains separating the beds? The new study that shows they give patients more than just privacy. That does it for us. Thanks for joining us and have a great afternoon.